Hi friends, welcome to Testing Tutorials Point. This is Lokesh, and today we are going to discussing about a static keyword in Java. Here is the memory management purpose we are going to use this static keyword. We can able to apply the static keyword in the variables, methods, block, and nested classes also. This static keyword basically belongs to the class, then instead of the class. There are three types presented, three different ways we can able to access the static one. We can able to apply this one, like we can able to do the variables, methods, blocks also we can able to do. Variables basically, a variable can be used to refer to the common property for all the objects, means which is not unique of each object. For example, company name of the employees and college name of student. That's a unique, right? That's not a unique one. Then we can use the static. A variable gets a memory only once in a class area at the time of class loading. And second way is the methods also we can able to use. If static keyword with any method, it is known as a static method. A static method belongs to the class rather than the object of a class. A static method can be invoked without need for creating an instance of a class. A static method can access a static data members and can change the value of it. Means when we are going to create a static a variable or a method, that without creating an object of that particular class, we can able to access those things. Like see, now I'm going to int count equal to 0, a simple one without a static keyword, this one. And I'm going to create constructor here, and here I'm going to use count plus plus, okay? But I'm going to print this count value count, and I'm going to directly creating an object, because without this one, without constructor, obj equal to new one, and I'm going to run this one. One is the value, because one time it is incremented. If I'm going to use 2 and 3 times, same object I'm going to create 3 times. Okay, I'm going to call 1, 2. Now it need to be display 3. It is 1, 2, 3, right? Now it is display 1, 1, 1, 1. Correct. Now I'm going to add here static keyword, and it 3 times calling, and here is go 1, 2, 3. Now 1, 2, 3, 3 times I called, 3 times it is, because the value it instant when we call that variable, it every time it will call the count, it will increase. Otherwise, see, if you are using this one normal without static variable, what will happen? First time it will think count is 0 and we need to increment, and second object time it is going to again it 0's position, again it will go the same way third time. But if you are using static keyword, it will every time will check the last, which is the incremented value, then it will go for the next. Like this it will incremented value. We can able to use the static keyword in variable time, and we can able to access the static keyword time using a method also. Int id and string name is my values, and third one is static a string college JNTU. I given the college name, and here I'm going to call two values. One is int id and string name. I'm going to use these two values, static output. This dot id and this dot name I'm going to use. Now I'm going to display while display values, and here I'm going to use the method ways parameters values, which is the values are presented. I'm going to change this value in the runtime. I'm going to use the insert the method. Okay. And here id plus space id name, and again I'm going to use here is college. We can able to call this one, and also I'm going to pass here the values. Also I'm going to pass one is id 1 and name Lokesh, and college is, I'm not going to pass college, but it will print all three values. I didn't call object of display. JNTU, but I want to dynamically, I want to change this college name JNTU1, right? Then I can use here a method static void change, and here is college name equal to A. Any name you can able to use, but if I'm going to access this one, I'm not going to create object of that one, but I'm directly going to call using the using this class name dot change. This is my method, and that is a static one. And I'm going to run. Now A is the college name, it is displayed as A. This way we can able to access methods without creating an object. This will save the memory of that. And last one is the block. Block of code, right? And here I'm going to create a static block, and I'm going to print the value as a static, and the same object I'm going to call inside main. Inside main one, and I'm going to run this one. It will print two values, static and as well as inside main. This way we can able to create a static block also. And maybe you will think, without main also can we able to run this class? Yes, we can able to run, but below 1.6, up to 1.6 we can able to run a class without main, but after that we have to use to run using the main only. That's all about the static one. If you like this video, please like my video and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.